Okay, everybody, if I could have your attention, please. First and foremost, I'd like to thank everybody for coming down tonight. Really appreciate it. It means a lot to us at the museum. And I'd like to introduce myself. My name's Jordan. I work here at the museum. Been working here since May. And we've got you all down here today to discuss an idea that we'd like to propose to yourself. And hopefully, after we've proposed this idea, we'll get a good discussion about taking this idea or other ideas forward and hopefully implementing them in the near future to help get Rochdale back on its feet as well. So, I'm Jordan, and I work here.
Yeah, I'm Claire, and I work with Jordan. I manage the museum, but I'll work with Jordan. Probably already know.
I'm enjoying what she said.
I'm Eleanor, and I work
Secretary of Rochdale Artists, and I don't work with anybody.
I'm Veronica, and I do work with
him. I'm Lisa Beckles, a volunteer here. I'm actually here on behalf of parent carers, cubs, little Berlions, any other group that might be. Why are you here tonight?
I'm Jack. I'm involved in Warren Development Trust, and we recently looked at how we produce cooperative values within Warren Development Trust to frame where it works. I'm quite interested in how cooperative schools would work with a cooperative community using those values.
I'm Nick Andrews, live in Lethbrook, and volunteer with a number of local organisations there, including Warren Trust, Burial House, I'm a neighbour of Keith.
I'm Keith, I'm a volunteer at the museum. I live in Littleborough, next door to Nick. John made me come. He said nobody else had a
strong guy who didn't come.
I'm wishing that I hadn't come because I didn't think I'd be on video.
My name's Rina Perucci Escobar. I'm a councillor for Wardle and West Littleborough, and I'm always interested in anything that can help the community.
I'm a latecomer. I'm Jonathan Hindle from Rochdale Development Agency. I'm here with my Town Hall hat on. I'm the project lead for the Town Hall Restoration Project, working with a number of people around the table, but would like to work with more and make it a truly cooperative venture.
Alright, thank you very much, everybody. Yeah, it is being filmed. This is because we want to post this film on our social media and on our website to show everybody the development of this museum and the changes that we're going through. So if people don't necessarily or aren't able to come to tonight, they're also able to keep track of our progress online as well. Right, okay, so as it's entitled, a community soup meeting, I'll explain a bit more about what I mean about the soup. People who arrived early have already had a bit of a feel of the handouts about what's been happening in Detroit, and I'll do a bit more talking about that as well. So, why we're here tonight is because, primarily by the fact that, as a museum, we've been very passive in the past, but now we're going through a lot of changes to become more active within the community. Hence why we've asked yourselves to come down and start getting ideas to how we can become more active and start cooperating. See what I did there? Cooperating with other people to start really help get Rochdale back on its feet as well. And just like the Rochdale Pioneers did in 1844, as they identified the need to for self-help and self-responsibility to start helping regenerate Rochdale, we've taken inspiration from their story, as we are at the birthplace of the modern cooperative movement, where you walked through to enter the building, taking the inspiration, and again in 2016 we've seen that we need to start to do more for the benefit of Rochdale and start provoking change as well. So I'll take you on to our first slide. So pioneering new ideas, just about what is and why soup. So the idea of soup is that it's about people coming together, donating our own time like we've done tonight, but also about donating some money and sharing a meal and start a discussion group as well. Though, as you've already identified, there's no soup as of yet. There will be hopefully in the coming months. And soups, like others around UK but also in the US, is a grassroots model for funding small to medium sized projects which are open to everybody and anyone, and it's through these community meetings that this happens. And like I said, it's open to anyone and everybody. All projects, all ideas are accepted and looked upon as well. And anybody who attends these meetings and gives a donation, they will be given a vote to choose or democratically elect the winning project, and the winning project will be given the funding raised on the door to start that project in Rochdale. And it's all about us taking it in our own hands to elect who or what we want to help push Rochdale forward. So why do it? So that's what it is. Why do it? So first and foremost, in a climate of cuts and things like that, which is pretty much non-existent through government arms, private support is dictated by values of priorities of their own organisations. Soups allow the opportunity for the community or for individuals to generate independent funding and participate throughout the grant funding to the selection process of the winning pitches. Not only is it about financial means, it's also about creating a space where people can come, connect and share their own ideas about helping Rochdale. It's also about networking, and it's also about creating that community hub feeling in Rochdale, which we don't seem to have. We need a focal point in which people can come and express ideas freely, and which will be listened by new people, really. They listen to not normal audiences that they reach. And it's also about encouraging cooperation as well amongst ourselves and amongst other branches of the community. And some of the examples, leaflets, there's only a few, so if you could pass them round, please. You can see how Detroit have been doing it. But a grant as well, it's simple and unbureaucratic in order to encourage broad participation from people from all backgrounds, all ideas, all beliefs. And it allows people who are not eligible for normal funding to gain other forms of support, whether that's financial advice or new networks as well. And we believe as a museum that soups are a powerful tool to start new conversations, practice democracy and fund new projects, fund new people, fund new ideas in the local area. However, the main emphasis is that we don't necessarily have to follow step by step other models of soups. About what tonight is about, it's about listening to the potential of doing a soup and getting everyone to give their own ideas and to modify it to fit the needs of Rochdale. So that's what is and why soup. And soups, what we've been looking at is, like I said, Detroit, which you've got some handouts. We've also looked at Newcastle, and we've also looked at Liverpool as well. In fact, myself, Claire and Eleanor went up to Liverpool to meet Patrick Hurley from the Social Enterprise Network, and we had a very fruitful meeting about the soup that they're doing down there in Liverpool, and he gave us a lot of advice and support about for our own soup as well. And I'm just going to show you a quick, short, 6-minute clip about Detroit soup just on YouTube as well, which will give you a real feel, real understanding of what they've been doing and the success that they've had as well. Yeah, you can just see how vibrant Detroit has become, and you can see how successful it has come, and that's a very long-term aim, but it goes to show what we can achieve once we put our heads in it, and once we start cooperating, and we can really start to move Rochdale forward as well. And you can just see, it just exemplifies the fact that local people have identified local needs and have expressed their ideas, their projects to local people who have funded their projects to help local people as well, and that's what it's all about. But you may be wondering why us that have chosen to do it, and it's simply because we're here with the Rochdale Pioneers Museum, and this is the birthplace of the modern cooperative movement, and the cooperative values and the cooperative principles of which we are trying to achieve, and we believe soup really falls into this as well, and it really shares its boundaries. So, as you can see, Law First, which was thought up from a man called Charles Howarth and James Daly, who was the Rochdale Pioneers' plan to start their cooperative. And it was to improve the social and domestic conditions of its members. People may be put off by the fact that it says members, but it says members because they wanted everyone to be involved. And this is what we want to do. We want you all to go back, tell everybody about this idea, hopefully how great this idea is, and tell friends and family that this soup is something that we need to support and we need to get behind and really get going. First and foremost, self-help. It's all about us in this situation, taking it upon ourselves to help the local area. Self-responsibility, like I said, it's up to us to do something about Rochdale. Democracy, everybody who donates will be able to, it will be given a vote to elect which project they wish to help regenerate Rochdale. And it's all about democratically electing those. Equality, everybody should be given a chance to project their own ideas and opinions, which they're necessarily not able to do so through other forms. And it's about bringing these ideas and projects to new audiences and connecting new people. Solidarity, we need to be solid, of course, as a local community. We need to stand together and work together to help get Rochdale back on its feet. And equity. I've done them the wrong way around, sorry about that, but equity, everybody treated justly and fairly. Anyone and everybody is invited to this soup meeting, all their ideas will be listened to equally and fairly as well. And like I said, it really ties in with the cooperative principles. So like this soup meeting, it's based on voluntary and open membership. It's all about people donating their times to help each other, and it's open to everybody. Democratic member control, like I said, it's all about people coming together and voting democratically for which projects. Member economic participation. I don't want to keep reinforcing the economic part of it. It's all donation based, but it's also about creating a safe space to get people to talk and project their ideas and create new networks as well. But money always helps. Autonomy and independence. It's about independent grants, free from restraints of where you'd normally get your normal forms of funding. Education, training and information, which is our fifth one. It's all about where people don't necessarily have the business head, but they have gotten the idea, they can meet someone who may have that support, may have that advice to help them get moving and put them in the right direction. Sixth principle, simply all about cooperation as well, working together. And seventh, and pretty much why we're here, is concern for the community. We know that Rochdale is not in the best situation anymore, so we need to change that and take it upon ourselves as well. I'm going to stop talking now, which you might be thankful for. So I'd like to invite you to share your ideas, your thoughts, suggestions. We want to know if this would work for Rochdale. If so, why? If you don't think it would work for Rochdale, why not? Just any thoughts you have, any critics, suggestions, we're all open. And we've just put a few questions just to provoke some thought if you're a bit stuck as well. And we want everybody to join in. Speak to the person next to you. Speak to me. Speak to any of the team as well here at the museum as well. So I'd like to thank you for coming down. Listening to myself ramble on, and I'd like to invite you to have an opportunity to speak your mind and get ideas or anything off your chest as well. So thank you very much as well.
Answer last questions as well.
Yeah, so before it all goes silent, if anyone would like to ask any questions. That's something that we've looked into. There's a few possible people, there's a few food co-ops that we hope might get on board. And we spoke to Co-op Food, who we've already used once before, but they have a £20 to help charities, organisations and things like that. So if we bring this idea forward, I'm sure they'll give us that £20 again, and we can get some like food and soup. It doesn't necessarily have to be soup. Speaking to Patrick Hurley, he said it's probably a safer bet doing something else because soup's a bit messy soup is just the title that is given to it. So we can work with different foods and things like that as well. So if you're only here for the soup, sorry. Go on, Tom.
Just a couple of really quick ones. So it sounds like a really interesting idea, and I think that's really great to hear about this. But there's a couple of things I just wanted to check. It sounds like you need quite a few people to get a significant amount of money to make a project work.
Yeah.
And the other thing, question I was wondering about, so the first one is roughly how many people do you think you need to make it work? How many do they have in Newcastle, how many in Liverpool? And the second one is, how do you check that the money is spent appropriately and wisely? And, you know, is there like a feedback system? Is there a kind of criteria that's laid out by the soup group saying actually you need to present these things in order to get funding, or is it just that was the best presentation, there you go, and we don't hear from them again? How does it work elsewhere, do you know?
Yeah, so speaking to Patrick, he said that they get about 20 to 30, if not more people-ish, and it's not all about getting loads and loads and loads of money. It's really small to medium-sized projects. It's not taking on massive projects who need hundreds and hundreds of pounds. It's just not for those people. It's for those people who need small injections of cash. So about £100, get 20 people, hopefully £5, hopefully some more. It's not all about putting in the money. It's, if they can get like £100 to get something, that project going, that's great as well. And the feedback form, and see if it's all spent wisely. Again, speaking to Patrick, they have some evaluation forms, I remember him saying. So we'll get something, get that wrote up.
Another important point to make about that is it doesn't always work. In Liverpool, the experience was sometimes it's really badly attended. It depends what the venue's like, and how much buzz they've managed to get before the event. But the point that he wanted to make was that even if the idea is a bit daft, or you know, people don't feel it's quite appropriate to fund, some of the stuff that came out of it for people who didn't then get funded and people were a bit uncomfortable with the idea was somebody else would chip in with some interesting advice that would help them to get it going in a different kind of way. So it's not, like Jordan said, it's not all about the money, it's just about the networking, the contacts that people build. And ideally, this kind of meeting gets people thinking about who they can then go away and say, please come back, you know, so we can start to build that buzz up. And the idea is that we want to, us in this museum and anyone else here around this table who wants to stay involved, will help us to build an energy around Rochdale which will create an audience for this.
And we're not saying that from this meeting it's all gone so well that we're going to do a soup and we're going to get hundreds and hundreds of people. Speaking to Patrick, who's done it himself, we're going to find some difficulties. We're not going to be successful straight away, but it's all about keeping the perseverance and getting this idea, getting people like yourselves to spread the word into other groups who I may have not thought about and not been in contact with, and really keep at it, because it's not like a short-term quick fix. It's going to take a couple of months to get something really going as well. So it's all about getting your ideas and working with you guys to get that going as well.
They also did say that they had an application system as well, didn't they, to make sure that the people were legit, that were coming to pitch for the night. He said in some cases there weren't that many people who would offer to come and pitch, so they just have everybody that applied. But more often than not, it gave them an opportunity to really look into the individuals that were applying to come and pitch. And they were able to do background checks on them in that way as well. And usually, because it's their members of the community, they're usually known within certain.
And quite often recommended by people like yourselves. You know, you might know, say, for example, a tenant who knows, you know, that's a really interesting project. Mm-hmm. You refer them to the soup idea, and that, you know, that kind of comes to mind in that way. But also, it's about people around this table really identifying the needs, know what we're going into it for, and the kinds of people that we want to start attending.
Yeah, it's. And the handouts that I've given you is just to give you a feel of how Detroit have done it. And I've just got it because I realise it's a bit small on there. This is just a model that Detroit have done. So we can really understand of what people are trying to achieve. It's not, and then just like whittle out the others who just have the money for just some random thing. It's getting serious people involved who want to do something, or who want to do a project as well. And it's not about just wasting time and money and help those. It was sort of,
I think it's a brilliant idea. What I would say is that there's a lot of really great people around who spend a lot of time trying to get people involved in places that have been very badly served by what's gone on economically and politically and all the rest of it. And I think it needs a lot of bravery, something like this. I'm involved in something called the Edge Fund, and that funds things that can't necessarily get funding elsewhere. And I think it takes a leap of faith. It means having to think that you have to, in some ways, tear up a bit in your head what you think is a legitimate project, what you think is legitimate reporting, what you think is legitimate fundability. I think it's absolutely right, you do need reporting back because that should inspire other people. But I think you have to be very creative in how you think about doing it. And one of the things I think we can think about in terms of the pioneers is when they got together, I don't want to be corny, but when they got together, they really did want to change the world. And they got together because they wanted to change the world. And I think, you know, I think it needs really creative thinking about how in any community, not just Rochdale, any community does reach out to different sorts of people, co-produces with them what might be good accountability, what might be good reporting, what might be good projects, and try and do it like that. Because there are a lot of incredibly good people who do try and turn things around and get involved in renewal and regeneration, but it's very hard. And I think being prepared to so-called fail is not necessarily fail. You know, I think we've got to rethink what we mean by fail. If three people turn up who've never go to anything like this before and scarper, well, you know, that's what you've got to deal with. So I think it's been quite creative thinking about how you might go about it.
And it just goes to show evidence is here now. You've actually all donated your time this evening to come and listen to our idea. So it goes to show that if we come back again, we'll bring more friends, bring more family, we can get something really going good. And if you speak to Claire, Johnny or Elena, I'm like a dog with a bone. I just won't give it up, honestly. Yeah, I'll just be back. I'll be back next week. Just. Yeah. Yes.
So it's the idea that you have those soups where in different places. So the idea would be that they would be within the whole borough of Rochdale, and they would be at different places. Because one of the things that seems to me is that, I don't know whether they still are the townships, who knows, but there are distinct parts of Rochdale, and I think within that you would get quite a lot of people coming from Middleton to something in Middleton about Middleton. And even within Middleton you get people from Borshaw, do you know what I mean? So
yeah.
It was actually quite a small area that you're talking about. You're not talking about the whole of Rochdale, you know?
Yeah, it was. Well, looking at Detroit, it just started off small scale in the centre of Detroit. These guys have been going at it for years, and
yeah.
There's quite a few years now. I think about 5 or 6, and they've gone from a small meeting into the middle of Detroit. Now they've got everyone in each borough. It's taken off that well. So the idea started in the town centre, so everyone can come round and get into the town centre just for the accessibility and easy to get everyone. But if it takes off that well, as you can see, we won't keep it here because we get about 50 people. We will move it around, have the chance for other people to get involved in as well. So we're more than willing. We've discussed it as well, like where the ideal locations may be as well. So it's something that we've been bearing in mind, and we'll see in the future if we're able to move it. We will probably move it.
And I guess within that, within certain locations, the people who live in that location will know the people that are trying to do that thing. They're the people who are going to be able to move things forward more readily and more easily about that neighbourhood, and that's part of that.
Yes.
It may even be that it cuts them off, so each neighbourhood just holds their own.
Little ones,
yes.
Yeah.
Which is actually a really good thing, because then it's kind of spreading it and then it's...
We want to emphasise, this isn't our idea. We've borrowed this idea, and we're not going to take ownership. This is all our ideas. This is all our ownership as well. So if anyone wants to come to us and say, oh, look, I like the idea what you're doing in Rochdale, we want some support in Middleton or some support in local boroughs, we're there to support them, and we'll help them as best as we can, as well as everybody else who is involved as well, which I expect. So yeah, we're more than open for it to share around as well. Yeah, Carol?
I was just visualizing this more on a practical term. You know, they have the diversity rewards that KYP is currently running and last year. And I'm just visualizing when we were in the town hall last year, there must have been around 300 people there. And they're currently asking for nominees. So this KYP is just one organization, but maybe one of the things we could do tonight is to think, when are other big events happening in Rochdale that bring together a similar amount of people? And for the time being, just to piggyback on those events, launch it. Because in those evenings, even if only half of the people were to say, yeah, I'm going to donate £5, you actually get into those £850, well, this was dollars, but you actually get into those 500 plus pounds region, which may be a difference to some local projects. And then obviously there need to be various conversations from now on with various partners that have already got that have the scale at the moment. So this might be an idea to do.
Yeah, and it's, hopefully you'll take it to other organisations who may be interested, and this might have to mean a follow-up meeting before we start something properly, or this might provoke an actual meeting. So. Just we'll see how successful and see if we can get some interest as well. Yeah.
I agree with this lady here. There is nothing I would like better, really, hand on heart, than the whole of the borough to become one. But I don't ever think it will, and I think it's such a shame. I mean, immediately when you put Rochdale, that's it, Haywood and Middleton switch off, unfortunately. And I would love a situation where it is the borough of Rochdale. I would love it for everybody to come together. And I think this is a fantastic idea for people like scout groups, you know, like a scout. I've just got funding recently for a scout group that just want some money for plants, things like that, just small amounts of money so that the children can learn how to grow vegetables, you know, anything edible. But I just worry about
this locality thing, and I do worry. I mean, I'm a councillor, I've worked for the council, and I've also been working for the NHS, and everything has to be Rochdale, Middleton, Harewood, and even down to Rochdale East and Rochdale West. And it would be good to find a common denominator to bring everybody together, because I think there are a lot of people, including me, that want to get involved in something that benefits the community, but not in isolation, so that we're just doing something in Littleborough, just doing something in Waldorf. And there's nothing out there. And the fact that somebody very recently tried to do this, I don't know if you know, don't you?
No, we've got
Dale Co-operative.
Oh, yeah, we've heard.
Yeah, and that didn't work for obvious reasons. I think the fact that if the council are leading this, it gives so much more credibility, and people are more likely, I think, personally, to jump on board and become engaged and become involved. I don't know what everybody else thinks, so that's what I think.
Yep.
I have 2 points. The first one was, even if you only get £5 off the 20 people in the room, once you start getting 20, 30 people in the room, I guarantee a local business or a local funder will turn up and say, here's some more money.
Yeah.
It's just obvious a local business would love to give more money, you could afford to give more money. So if you wanted a bit more scale, once you set the thing up, the money will come, I think. You know, that's the first. The second point was, we've done something similar for workers, and what we really found is you can have a really big grand plan and try and involve everybody and get the local authority or whatever involved, and you just get bogged down in discussion. I'd say just set the thing up, get 20 people in a room, and then think about involving the local authority and other people. But just do it once, and it'll probably, the first time it'll probably fail miserably, and then the second time you do it, invite the local authority and other people, because the second time it'll be a lot better.
Yeah. So
I think, just get on and do it.
It kind of like shares the same point. So it's like organising this was a bit afraid that we won't get anyone come in, everyone will just shove it to a side. Evidently, we were wrong. Everybody's turned up. We've just done it. We've just set a date and invited as many people as possible, and some people have turned up. And I'm not going to say I've not invited everyone in Rochdale. I don't have the contacts. I don't have the networks. I don't necessarily know who to invite. I've been using Claire's, Jonathan's, Eleanor's contacts, whoever I can think of. And it's all about also getting you together, spread the word. And when we organise a soup, it might fall on its face, but like I said, I'm a dog with a bone, I won't give up. So as long as you guys keep turning up and supporting, it will bring just plus ones, plus twos, we'll start getting something really good going. And I believe that given the right energy and time and effort, I think we can do something and start creating links across boroughs. As well, even if it's just one or two people, and then it just start like a snowball, won't it, and hopefully get into something a lot bigger as well.
Our problem isn't really money, to be honest with you. We've got a project up and running, and it works because we've got funding from Mike for Life and from Rochdale Borough Council. Not a lot of funding, but about £120 a quarter there, so it's not a lot, it's enough to keep it going. But what we need are people. We need volunteers to actually deliver the service we give. It takes about 2 hours, 2.5 hours a week. And we need the people. So, £5 isn't a lot, but the person will be a whole lot.
Yeah. Like I said, I was not...
And I wonder how that could buy into this.
I was emphasising the fact that it's not all about financial aid, it's all about people power as well. And try and create that community hub. I don't know if anyone wants to disagree with me, but personally, I'm only from Milne Row. I don't feel like there's a community hub or a community spirit in Rochdale. There's nowhere that if I was from Rochdale, I'd go, it all happens in that place, or it's all at that place. We want to change the museum as from a passive one that's next to the barn to that place, have you heard what's going on this week? And constantly checking what's going on and what's going on. And also working with Touchstones as well, with Tom, really turn Rochdale on its head and start becoming a bit more buzzing, and people are wanting to check, instead of going to Manchester or Bury, what's happening in Rochdale as well. And this is what it is about as well.
Can I say as well? because whilst £5 might not seem a lot of money to some people, to really get the community involved with any project, there are so many people who £5 would be a tremendous amount of money.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they are also the people who probably will benefit the most from being in this kind of either having opportunities for volunteering or they're having something specific for their community. And I do think that perhaps what you charge on the door also needs to be considered in terms of maybe where you are localising a meeting, you know, for that community as well.
Yeah,
yeah, we wouldn't charge £5.
No, yeah, that was
any
just
donation.
It was just an example, it was just a donation, because we don't want to prohibit anyone who can't necessarily give that money. We don't want to prohibit them from coming. It's all about the platform to allowing those people who have not necessarily got that platform to share their ideas, to come, speak to people and say, look, I've got this idea, I haven't got any money. And people say, oh, I've got the support here for you. And all about that community spirit, cooperation as well, and networking. So, yeah, Eileen?
Can I just comment? There's all the time. Bit dubious about this introduction of capitalist theme into a community group. Also, I would also like to say that we do already have a cooperative members group where anybody can come and anybody can put a project to us for any about anything at all. We will try to finance that. But the other thing I'd like to say is that there's a great deal of difficulty here that you, first of all, what you need is a small community who is interested in a project, and they will then bring that project and put it to you. I'm presuming this is right with it. And then the people who are there then vote on who is going to get this money. So how do we go about deciding that, first of all, one group isn't bigger than another and about 20 of them all turned up and all voted, which is something that has to be sorted out. And like I said, I can understand very well why it's needed and necessary in Detroit, but I would like to know a lot more about how they've gone on with it in Liverpool, which is, I think, nearer to us. I can see where there's benefits in it. I can see where there's a lot of good that could possibly come out of it. But I can also see that there's a tremendous amount of grassroots work that you would have to do before you actually got as far as getting a meeting where people come and put their projects to us. And would it be held here?
First and foremost, it's not about, we're not out to compete with the members group. If you can bring your group to us and also say we've got this funding and be here and witness who those projects are from, that would be great. I mean, we'd love to incorporate yourselves and anybody. It's all about working together as well. And Liverpool, he said, like I've said before, they didn't get it up and going and running straight off like the others did in Newcastle and Detroit. It's all about just plugging at it and creating or promoting this. And it will require a lot of legwork, a lot of speaking to, using our own connections and networks. And I feel from this initial meeting, I mean, I think there's about 20 of us here, if not more, 20, 25 of us. If to the next meeting everyone brings a friend or just gets a couple of people to come, that's, we're hitting 30, 40 people. Not necessarily £5, a couple of quid. And it's not all about getting massive funding for like groups, but it will require a lot of grassroots, and we're not going to deny that fact as well. I understand where you're coming from, the projects, what's stopping them from bringing loads and loads of friends as well. It's something that we'll have to work out.
Patrick actually mentioned that very briefly, didn't he,
yeah,
when we met him, and he said it was an issue in Liverpool. It's bound to happen, and it's something that they can't control, but he said there's an element of trust that you have to embed within the people that come, and you've just got to go with the flow. You've just got to accept it. If that's what happens, then that's what happens. He says, but the people that lose out also network and still gain something. He used an example of a young man that needed the money to buy pizza and beer for
a development day
that he was running. The actual development day sounded amazing, but then at the end of his pitch he said, and I need the money to buy the pizza and beer to feed the people that come. Well, of course he lost out completely, because that what was a silly thing to say. However, Patrick said that he was one of the most successful people on the night, because the links and the contacts that he made of people that actually jumped in to help him, because the actual thing itself sounded so good, he came away being able to do it anyway. So it kind of swings and roundabouts, and you've got to take the rough with the smooth.
And in a way, it helps, he was saying that people who come again and again and again with their ideas, you know, it was helping them to develop their skills in how they were applying for small amounts of money. And eventually, because they're getting more people contributing and voting than people pitching ideas, eventually, you know, everybody was going to get the money, because, you know, people were just developing their skill and they were bringing a better idea each time they came on. People are invited to pitch the same idea again and again and again if they want.
And in terms of adding cooperative elements to it, that's why we need people here tonight. We need the ideas. We realise there is a capitalist element to it. However, with a bit of thought, let's turn it on its head a little bit. Let's throw something else into the mix. Make it more cooperative. Change it around. It doesn't have to be that particular form. It can be anything.
Yeah.
It's just an idea.
It's just a model that we've looked at and which can be moulded to meet our needs. That's what tonight is about, to listen to your opinions.
Really
good. Yep.
Are you going to crowdfund as well?
We've not necessarily thought about crowdfunding, but I think it's more of a face-to-face thing, and just turning up on the night and showing your support.
It was like the unplugged version of crowdfunding, whereas crowdfunding is mainly based kind of on social media and internet. This is something that's kind of face-to-face, here and now, back to basics.
I was thinking, because obviously they're saying about a small group, getting the message out to Middleton, Harewood, Castleton.
Be a good idea.
The social media, of course, is the one thing that everybody is plugged into via all the phones and everything else.
Could be something that we could start up, you know, and a web page for it. It's on Twitter, it's on Facebook page.
Yeah.
This is a really stupid, random thing as well.
No.
Are we going to stick with Rochdale soup?
No. We've just come up with that.
It to be completely everybody. Why not pioneer soup? Or anything, you know.
That's what we were thinking.
It's a random left wing thing.
Like I said, it's open to agreement, disagreement. It's all about having a common sense.
I was just thinking what the councillor said, which is we need to be identifiable to an entire area. If this is good.
Yeah,
that's a good suggestion.
We was thinking, by the way, coop soup. By the way, that, just to put that out there. So we thought it was super.
We don't need to be emphasised on the Pioneers Museum. We need to emphasise on community.
Yeah.
So even just calling it maybe even just community soup.
Yeah.
Kind of.
So
it has got cooperative spirit about it. I mean, I was at the launch. We hosted the launch of the last so-called cooperative that didn't feel very cooperative. This feels much more equity and equality, and organic as well, so none of the baggage of previous systems. And I think getting away from the place thing is perhaps quite important, being neutral about place and seeing what happens. And reviewing it, I guess, as you go along. It needs a few wise heads who keep an eye on it.
Let's just stick at it, yeah. So, and like I said, it's all about cooperative values, principles, and just being open about everything as well.
I was just going to say one other thing. When I said about being outside the box and being brave, if people ask for pizza and beer and they've got a reason for that, in other words, otherwise the event wouldn't happen, then actually maybe it's all right, you know. I just think it's important. I think that's what. But the other thing I wanted to say is, although I sort of cringe at the beauty contest side of it, which is basically what you're doing, I think it is actually a really good idea. And I think, I just know that a lot of people, young people in particular, you can see the buzz they would get out of standing up, even if they're being daft, it doesn't matter. Putting their idea across, because they're used to sort of doing that performing, really, and that's in a way what it is. So, you know, I think some of us might feel a bit less comfortable with that, about, you know, trying to sell our idea. I think it's a really brilliant idea, and I think the skills you could develop would be excellent. So I can see how it really could be attractive to people. It's got to be fun. It's got to. We know it's got a purpose, and a good cooperative purpose, but it also has to be fun.
People want to go. We have recognised the fact that it is a bit. I know we're the Cooperative Museum, and we know it is a bit about competing for funding. We have recognised that, but we've also recognised the fact that it's small pots of money. So to be too cooperative might kill it off. Like in regards to if you're sharing a pot of £50 between four projects, it's only what £12.50 as well. So we've really toiled. We've been discussing this for a couple of weeks, and we've looked at different forms of which way we can make it as cooperative as possible and meet as many cooperative kind of values and principles as possible. And we feel that though it might not hit each and every one of them, it's maybe the best model in which we can start get projects going. And because of the funding issue, and we're not expecting hundreds and hundreds of pounds, it's that it, to be so cooperative, it might kill it with sort of like kindness kind of thing. So that's just something to a bit of food for thought about that element as well. So you might not necessarily agree. We don't 100% agree with everything, but it's something that it's more of a necessity, we believe, we think.
And it could also lead towards more of a regeneration of cooperativism in Rochdale.
Yeah.
Okay? It could start out with something that isn't so cooperative, but if we do eventually gain so much momentum that we can reintroduce a bit more real competition.
And again, to go back, it's not all about the financial issue, it's also about coming, pitching your ideas. If you don't necessarily win, you might get the support and networks there as well, so you're not losing out totally as well. So hope that's our aim, that's our underlining goal as well. Yeah?
We do like participatory budgeting, the money's already there, but community groups have to come and bid for it, and it's a very simple process. Stand up for a couple of minutes, tell us what you think, and then members vote. And you know, it's varying degrees of success. What I like about this model is ours is quite dry, I would say. You know, it's at an event, people come, it's quite formal, you've got all your voting, and I like the idea that this is more social. Mm-hmm. And we do get people coming along, and you know, that is the basis of democracy. If you bring 100 people, you're going to get 100 votes. You know, there isn't much you can do to avoid that. But, you know, it does work for us in that way. But this is a different model, but I can see quite a lot of similarities to it.
See, and off this meeting, we've already got two kind of pots of funding that if we can bring it together, and not necessarily bring all your money or else you're not coming. like, just if we can have, like, even just a small proportion, that's amazing. We've already got some great funding there as well, so it goes to show there's already promise as well there. Yeah.
Don't think well, did you money?
No, I was
just... No, then we have a scheme.
It's all about cooperation, sorry. I'm not trying to strong ground me to be good, sorry.
I really like the idea that you just would start it and then just see what would happen. It would evolve naturally and it would just work its way through and there's no rules and just go and whatever happens on the night. I really like that idea. And what also struck me is that it's taken, I think I've got a really, really clear understanding, as we all did, but when I was coming here tonight, I was struggling to understand what it was about. And what we're trying to appeal to here isn't organisations. Many of us here are representing a group that we work with, but actually what we want to attract is individuals. And so it's about finding out how we can badge that it's clear and understandable to an individual, they can just turn up and participate, rather than needing to have a representative organisation behind them. And I wonder whether maybe that's possibly a next step, is to create something that succinctly describes what it is. And obviously it's for all of us to go and speak to all the people we know and try and describe it personally as well. But I think that probably be the an initial struggle we might need to overcome.
Yeah, and we've, by the way, we've got...
condensed soup.
I wanted to say that.
Yeah,
sorry. And just, I'd like to point out the fact we've got Rochdale College and Sixth Form right on our doorstep, who have huge, I'm guessing, huge business departments for business students, who I'm sure have got loads of ideas. So that's one thing that we can tap into. So there's already one sort of place we can start. Yep.
We talk a bit sort of advertising it as a project. We thought about trying to get media involved, so The Observer or MEA, and sort of doing it as a good news story, and then you could like say exactly what you want to get involved with the people, and it might reach more people than just word of mouth than people in the room. Mm.
Yeah, hence, well, we got rung by Kirsty. From Rochdale Online, yeah, who said she rung up about wanting to do a piece about it. And as you can see, we've got filming by Andy over there, who's being hidden. Sorry to point you out, Andy. But we've got filming to help promote this and spread the word, so get it on social media and on our website, see what we're about, hopefully generate some interest as well. So, yeah, like I said, again, dog with a bone, I'll just keep going out. I will be on that high street trying to generate interest. Don't you worry, I've done it before, several times. Like I said, it's just about talking to people, get people in through the door as well. Carlos?
I think, even just the video, as long as you phrase it clearly, you know, and just say, how would this look like in... And then you're careful with the phrasing. We don't want to say Rochdale, we just say in our borough or whatever. and you just watch this video, and it explains a lot, but then obviously it's just to clearly say, this is, yes, it's in Detroit, it's not here, but how would this look like here? Who would get involved? Or something along those lines. And that's a tool, actually, if you share that link, that's a tool that in individual conversations I will be using. I mean, I'm thinking, for us as Near Neighbors, it might be a really nice project to start off with. I'm thinking Near Neighbors, and also The Challenge is another project which runs the citizenship courses for...
Yes, yes.
So they would be, I think they would might be interested in actually getting young people in setting something like this up in the summer. But I'm also thinking in terms of Near Neighbors, for us it would be quite nice. We've got lots of Near Neighbors funded projects. Maybe they want to come together. And rather than just me saying come together to get to know each other better, which may not be as much of an incentive, but actually to say come together and maybe you get some extra cash on as well from the meeting. So maybe that might be something that might work for us. So it's definitely worthwhile trying.
Yeah, it definitely is. Yeah, it's something that we could take forward and bring loads of groups together like you've got as well. So, yeah.
I'm just wondering, John, it sounds like we're all really positive about this. What do you imagine that the next step would be following this meeting? And is it the Pioneers Museum that are going to take forward and organise the next meeting? Or are you looking to outsource to another group? Or and what sort of timescales were you initially thinking?
Well, we was initially thinking that it will be in the next coming months, just because it'll take a few months to generate the interest. It's taken us a month or so just to get this one together.
Would we need another meeting similar to this before a soup meeting, or do you think we should
just jump straight in?
Soup,
right,
in
there we go. See, we've all decided that we should just jump straight in, both in at the both feet in at the deep end.
No,
2 months. So that's what I was hoping for. In the next couple of months, I'll just give a date, circulate it around to everybody. Everyone's got a date, and we'll get that going. Where it may be, we'll see how successful or the interest that we get. I was just thinking here, but if this is only a capacity of 50 people, so if it's so much, we can look to other people getting involved, Touchstones to throw you in it, or the town hall, or you know, them kind of like big areas where we can host a good meeting, because I'm sure as soon as we talk to people about this idea, and we use our connections in the council as well.
You won't be at the town hall for free.
Oh, it's worth a shot, wasn't it, as well? So, I'm sure if we take it forward to people, it doesn't necessarily have to be a museum, any space, I'm sure that they'll be able to offer us something.
Are you taking email addresses as well to communicate with?
Good. Yes, of course. I've got everyone's kind of saved who've come in, but I've got a few people.
List.
Yeah, so I've got a few people who I don't think I've got already emailed. So yeah, we'll get everyone to leave their emails as well for that as well. So we'll get a date together. We'll put, is everyone okay for around 2 months' time? Is there anyone who's got a very busy in a couple of months' time? No.
Are you gonna brush up on your soup making skills between now and
then? Yeah. Gonna go to some cookery classes as well.
We do need ideas around the food providers, I think.
Yeah.
The idea is that we use cooperatives and
on that, would the college, for instance, Hop would have the production kitchen there, is that something that we could involve the students at doing?
Yeah.
That?
Yeah.
That would be great if we do that.
You're just better off with bread, patty,
yeah,
and cheese.
Yeah. So, like I said, if we really struggle for the food caterers, we've got because we have a lot of co-op food members coming in for tours and meeting us, and I've spoke to quite a few of those, and they've just said go to your local cooperative store, and I'm sure they'll be able to help you out. Just go to the manager. I've done it before, and I think I'll be able to do it again. Hopefully, anyway. So it's.
We need more than £20
worth
of food,
though.
Yeah. I'll get the soup when it's on offer. Don't worry. Yeah, Liesl.
Know what you do at a
faith
supper or Jacob's Joy, where you all bring a little
something.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't think of that. So
if you circulate a list, then people can say, I'll bring the X or I'll bring the Y, can't they? And then that way,
Like I said,
30 rolls of bread then.
Yeah.
No soup.
It doesn't necessarily have to be soup. By the way,
I'll go for soup. I like soup.
If we're going for soup,
pies,
yeah.
I think the important thing is that, from what I gather, is the soup and the reason, I don't know whether you found out why they called it soup and why they serve soup, but it would make sense. I mean, in Liverpool, it's scarce, just put everything in. And there's sort of an analogy there in the food. And so I think it's not just any food, actually. I think it's quite important for the branding of this. I know it sounds strange to call it branding, but that's how we call things in this day and age anyway. But you actually it needs to sort of fit into the theme. So if we call it soup or salad or whatever, you just say, because everybody puts something in the pot. That's where the analogy comes from.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think that has to stay true. As
chocolate.
Good point. Community chocolate.
Is there a special Rochdale? Is there a Rochdale speciality that would have to serve? I'm thinking of obviously like Scouse.
I was thinking rag puddings as well. Right.
Nothing you can just all chuck in a pot.
Like I said, it's this idea. This is.
It's a shame we didn't ask the board to come.
Putting them on the spot, aren't we? this is what the meeting's for. What do you think? What do you think will work? It's only called a soup because other previous models have done soup and have served soup. But what do you think? Does anyone like to suggest anything?
Perhaps part of it isn't Pancho's dictating, but starting to come up with some of the ideas. So if you run that first event and you do manage to get 50 people there, these are the people you're hoping will get involved and hopefully benefit from the project that you're trying to do. So I think the decision making now perhaps doesn't need to be as rounded. It can just be part guidance, and then when you actually run the event, those that are there might be able to offer more insight and large numbers.
But it might not be a bad idea to keep the same names, so that way people who are coming at it from Liverpool or Newcastle think, oh, Rochdale's got a zoo, and before you know it, you've got a whole network.
So what are you saying? Just because we're keeping with the soup, we can associate with other people.
Link up with other soups all over the place.
The branding of the soup. I know there was a soup network around the world that I found, I think, but I couldn't find it before. I wanted to show everyone in it. It was crossed out on the Detroit soup. But like you'll see, pretty much every other soup, there's also one in Sheffield. They literally are around the world, and they are pretty much stuck with the soup title. So I think
it's
like, I think, we'll stick with soup. So it's like the association.
Patty business. business, we want it.
Patty, this is... yeah.
Bring your own mug.
That's a good idea.
Bring your own mug for your own...
It serves on washing off.
Yeah, definitely. So, look, the ball's rolling. So keeping with the soup idea, with the soup branding, excellent. And bring your own like mug, so great, yeah.
Can I just say one thing about where? Go where people are, you know. No disrespect to the town hall, no disrespect to here. Why not think, look, that, you know what I'm saying? Oh, let's have a whip round. Go to a community centre somewhere, and that can be moved around. Go to where people are.
Yeah.
You know, rather than expecting to come to somewhere, you know, that the other events can be held in those more iconic places. But to start it off, go to where people are.
Yeah, I was just thinking, from my personal view, if anyone wants to disagree with me, just the town centre, it's just easier for everyone to get in, just for accessibility. But I don't know where else. So does anyone? Anyone got any thoughts where else might be a bit more suitable?
Yeah,
but if you're aiming at young people, it needs to be young people's venues that they're comfortable in. So I'd be taking to the college or the sixth form college and saying, have you got a space we can run it here? Yeah. Because you want them there. And
yeah.
They're gonna be, it's going to be a venue where they're comfortable. If that's all we're aiming at.
Yeah.
Yeah, one of the gyms.
Sports
hall.
Yeah.
Sports hall.
Exactly. That sort of place.
Yeah, that would work.
How about a mosque?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. A mosque would work very well.
Because we've got lots of mosques in Rochdale.
I think secular, it doesn't mean it can't go into different places, but maybe for the first one it would be good to have secular.
Squeeze everybody in here. Make it work
here
for the first one, don't you think?
Yeah.
Spirit has to begin here.
We,
what if we make a mess?
We could
actually use the hall as a museum, so we could do the pitching up here, and people could stand and watch the pitches, but then the rest of the time they can feel free to wander around
and
network and everything else. We could make it work.
Yeah.
If you get stuck, they've got big rooms in the co-operative on Manchester Road, which is where we hold our meetings now, and they're very big, and we don't have bodies there. if you let me know.
Yeah, so we've already got several venues then, just within
That's
a couple
great.
Of minutes already as well. Would anyone like to add anything else?
Should the first one be about us pitching to the young people to produce a video of what a soup is?
Sorry, what was that? I missed that.
Instead of young people coming and pitching at us for money, we actually pitch at young people, a group of young people that might be on a video production course or, I don't know, marketing course or whatever, to actually produce our marketing for us, and that they will get the money that's collected at that soup to go away. So we reverse
good thinking.
It.
That's
yeah,
it's
reverse.
Pitch, isn't it? Except, but that could be one of many pitches that goes in first. But yeah.
Yeah, well, a pitch, but us pitching at a group of them, and so you're almost inviting the young people to come and experience it, but beyond the not be there to present, but to actually receive a pitch, and then they can go away and say yes, there's, and then we end up selecting the best video, the best bit of marketing.
But you don't want your first meeting, though, to be that principle of what the whole project was about.
I can see where you're coming from. It could be an idea that where we give them a small proportion of the money to make something. I don't know, what does everyone think about giving them?
It's a difficult one, because if the core concept is you can only vote and take part if you put money in the pot, that's either a core concept or it's not a core concept. And I think you don't want to get into a situation where people are turning up not putting any money in the pot and asking for stuff.
Yeah.
Because then it'll just degrade into the randoms turning up. So I just think, if the core concept is you can only pitch if you put money in, then you've got to keep that right from the start.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
Well, people who want to be involved in a video, why don't you organise a separate meeting for those people and then do that.
Create a video
yeah.
that we could use.
For the pitch, for the social media side.
So yeah, offering them experience and things, not necessarily the money, but the experience.
If you want to create a video to explain what the project is, then people who want to be involved in that video, you meet up a month before the actual suit event and create the video and then put it out on social media, ready for the
first meeting.
What
yeah.
it is.
Yeah. Yeah. So
do we actually need a video? Why don't we just put you in front of a camera and you blog?
Because we need some entertainment, we need some... We want something serious, not comedy. I know, we need some pizzazz, don't we, or something like that. I don't know. Just me talking to a camera, I don't know. I do that, I was preparing myself to go into the college and just speak to like business teachers and students and just pitch the idea to them as well. A video, but yeah. So we were toying with the idea of doing video blog / YouTube. So with the ideas, this could be our initial one, and then we can.
When that module is delivered, so you can't really dictate your time frames, but it's worth finding out when.
Yeah.
Whatever's worked at this time of year.
But I wonder whether these ideas probably just need to go them towards Jordan and need to talk about them and prioritise
yeah.
and work through what needs to happen at that point,
yeah.
Rather than all of us trying to work out what the right thing is. I think the bones of it is that we've got this idea of a suit, which just crack on with it with that one key idea, and then we can bring in people. Jordan
yeah.
can do whatever innovative things he can think of to bring in all sorts of people, and we can all try and help and drag a lot of people to the next suit.
Yeah.
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 Would you be able to send me your contacts for the college then? Because that'll be good.
Sure.
Thank you very much. As well. Would anyone else like to add anything before?
I think you're brilliant.
thank you very much. hopefully it was all right enough for you to come back. So I'll get a date organised and hopefully see you at the next one. And hopefully we won't flat.
Can you send out the link to the YouTube video and this?
Yes.
Would you like me to circulate that?
Yeah.
Everything.
You need our addresses. You've got everybody.
Yeah, Claire will get you a piece of paper and thing it with that organised. I'll get this sent to everyone. All you need to do is just go on Google and Detroit Soup. They have so much information. They have this, but they also have like an actual welcome pack, which is like 20, 30 pages long, which will just take you step by step and step. There's also Liverpool Soup and Newcastle, which I can also link you to as well.
Quickly, just one more information. So if everyone's giving your email addresses, perhaps if you could just make contact with us all, and then I'm going to go away, and I'll be sat on the tram going back to Manchester thinking, oh, do you know, I wish I'd said that. Perhaps we may want to feed back into Jordan when you're sat having your cereal in the morning and something pops into your head. So perhaps it might be a good thing.
I'll get an email together, including everybody, if that's what you all would like, just to share that. And I'll see if I can think of something like try and create a platform in which everyone can start communicating with each other as well. Feel free to email us. Is everyone okay to share the email addresses with everybody? Good. great. Excellent. So I'll get like a general email just to say like, hi, this is everybody. Save, create new links. And hopefully I'm not sure what I could do, but try and create a platform where we can add new people in. As well.
And Facebook pages are really handy.
Facebook page, that's, yeah, exactly. Thank you very much. Yeah. So I'll create a Facebook page. I'll see if that's, I'll get that up and going. Are you not on Facebook?
Email.
email. So I'll get an email, I'll get a Facebook page,
Twitter.
We'll get a Twitter,
Instagram
web pages, a whole new job for me. But yeah, I'll
just pass in a piece of paper around. So if we've not got your email address, if you just pop your email address on the front.
Yeah, and before you go, if you could just tell anyone and everyone who you think may be interested in to this first meeting and see what we can get going. And just tell everyone that there's an opportunity for people to start getting projects together and ideas together to pitch for actual funding. So I think that'll appeal to them. What food we may offer looks like soup. It does looks like a common consensus.
Any
particular
type?
Vegetable. Yeah. So
no
yeah.
Carrots.
No.
So
yeah,
minestrone.
Alright, excellent. So I'll get a few varieties. So just spread the word, really, and let's start getting this going.
Might be easy, John, just do cups if you're all bringing
your own cups. The recessions, it is hard. Like that's really it. So again, thank you very much for all coming down tonight.
Thank you.